So today I have come up with a new topic. So topic name is Azure Recovery Service. So Azure Recovery Service, I think most of the people you heard about this service. Okay, as the name suggests, its service is only used for business continuity or disaster recovery scenarios. Okay, so it is a native service of Microsoft Azure, right? It works similar like your Azure Migrate. But this service is made for different purpose. So we'll go through that. So first we'll talk about the features, and then we'll talk about the what are the prerequisite steps, and then we'll see your actual demo. Okay, so let's start. So about feature. So see, as mentioned by the first feature one, right? Simple BCDR solution. So BC stand for business continuity, and DR stand for disaster recovery. So through one Azure portal, through that service on the Azure portal, I can create, manage my replication. I can do a failback or failover to the same portal. Okay, so it is a single pane of glass. Second part about Azure VM replication. So take an example that my VM is running in US East, and I have to replicate my VM from US East to US West. So I can use this service to do that VM replication as well, okay? Or you can take the example of primary site in is US East and secondary site is US West. So in that case also, I can use this service. Then the on-premise VM replication. So in the on-premises, if I want to do a replication, I want to maintain a DR site in cloud. So this service can be helpful to maintain a secondary site into the cloud. If there is an outage on premises, then I can quickly enable the services or enable the VMs to start the workload from the on premise from the cloud. Then a workload replication. So as of now, this service supports your Hyper-V. It supports the VMware workload. It supports your on premises workload like Windows, Linux VMs, right? So it supports that kind of workload. And then the next point about data resiliency. Data resiliency, when you actually start replicating the data from on-premises, the storage account, it holds the data, okay? And if you want to quickly start the VM into the cloud, then this data from the storage account will be used to spin up the VM. So the data won't be lost anywhere, okay? And even though storage account supports GRS, so Global Replication Service, So data is also spread across the globe. So there is a high durability of data and uptime as well. Then RTO, RPO target. So if you go to any organization or any project, there is a set limit of RTO, RPO, which you have to achieve. So disaster recovery may help you into that. Okay. Disaster recovery can do the continuous replication for VMware, for Hyper-V, okay, even for the your on-premises workload also, right? Your physical box also. So in that, for Hyper-V, it support up to 30 seconds of replication. Okay, so it's a good factor of about it. Then keep app consistent over the failover. So the data which is taken into consideration is app consistent. So the, your disk data in a memory or transaction data also gets stored inside the snapshot. And then testing without disruption. So I can test my DR, okay, without interrupting my application workload into the production. So as a company standard, company used to do a DR drill, okay, in the quarterly or once in a 6 month kind of, okay. So it support that as well. So you can do that. Okay, I think I talked about features. I hope you're clear with the feature. Let me move on to the next one about the for prerequisite. Okay? So this is the prerequisite which we have to take it in consideration. We have taken in consideration for demo purpose. So now today I am going to replicate one Hyper-V machine from my virtual VM to the virtual VM considered as a physical box. Okay, or the virtual VM running inside the Hyper-V on premises. Okay, for example, so I'm trying to replicate my Hyper-V VM, okay, to the cloud. Okay, that's my goal. So first step is that I need to set up a Hyper-V host VM and one client VM. Okay, so I have done that as well. I can show you quickly. So this is my Hyper-V VM host machine. Inside that, I'm running one prod VM. Okay, this is the UI of this VM. Okay, and then what next? Next is create a recovery service vault. So this and configuration also. So recovery of service vault is very important where because you are taking a backup of the your replicated data. So over here, if I go to the screenshot over here, let me click on recovery vault. Okay. So in recovery service vault, you can see that I have created one recovery vault, Raga DR vault over here. So this is being used in our set replication or site recovery service. Okay, over here, I just updated some few parameters, which I will quickly show you. Over here, if I go to backup over here, in backup configuration, click on update. Over here, rather than keeping the geo redundant, I have just selected a locally redundant. So it's up to you how you want to keep it, okay, your replication type. And then for encryption, I have kept as it is. I haven't changed it, but you can do that. You want to bring your own key, customer own key, and through that you can encrypt your data as well. This option also given by them. Okay, and then security setting. Security setting, there is a normally option, is the soft delete is enabled, but in my case, I have purposely disabled it because I don't want to return the data. But if you want to return the data, you can go ahead and enable it. So even though you delete the data will be available for particular days as per the limit you set over here. Okay. But that's it about it. Okay. Let me quickly go back to PPT. So now the third point about the VNet and subnet. So for this exercise, I am creating the two VNet and one subnet inside that for my DR VNet and test VNet. Okay, so DR will be used for replication purpose and test VNet will be used for testing purpose. Okay, let me show you that as well. So you can see these two separate VNet I created. This is the first VNet where my VM host is running. The DR VNet is where I will replicate the data and test VNet where I will do actual test failover. Okay. And then last part about the storage account. So I'm going to create one storage account which is being used for data replication. Let me show you that as well. I have done that already to save time over here. So you can see this. This is the storage account I have created, Raga ST object migrate. Okay, so I think we'll go back to our PPT. And so this is prerequisite step I have already done. So let me start with actual demo. So over here, first let me type the Azure Recovery Service Vault. Okay. Let me go inside that. And then I will go to set recovery option over here. Okay, so if you see the three options they have given, Azure Virtual Machines, VMware Machines to Azure, and Hyper-V Machines to Azure. So in my case, I have already set up the Hyper-V machines, that's why I will choose this option. So rather than doing from here, I will do it from my virtual machine, from VM host, because I have to download the agent as well, and I have to install that. Okay, let me open that. Okay, so it is already open at my side. So let me quickly show you that. Let me open that again. Okay. So let me click on the prepare infrastructure, this option. Okay. Over here, I will just select, I have done it already. So if you compare this with Azure Migrate, over there, we used to do a discovery assessment. So if you see here, I'm not doing any kind of discovery assessment over here. So already I made my plan and based on that, I am just starting with the recovery part over here. Okay, let me click on next. Okay, over here I will set as a no. Okay, I am not using any system central VMM, so that's why I just put a no. And then I have to create one site. So this is just name. I can just quickly show you that. Okay, I had a Hyper-V site. So this is just name you have to give here. So already given the name over here. Can you see that? Right? Raga dash dev dash Hyper-V Hyper dash V. Okay. And then let me now next is let me put my Hyper-V server, which is running on premise. Okay. So in my case, it is not on premise. In case here is a this is a virtual machine. Which is I have set up as a VM host. Over here, I am just showing you that. Okay. So this is my VM host, which is I am going to register over here. Okay. So just quickly see the what is the option they are given you, right? So they have on premises. If you are Hyper-V running on premises, then you make sure that you should have a Windows Server 2012 R2 or above. Okay, so that is requirement. And if your Hyper-V host doesn't have internet, then you need to allow some Microsoft URLs through proxy settings, okay? And then you need to download the set recovery provider exe. Let me click on that. Okay, it will download over here. Okay, also I need to download the registration key. Without that, I cannot install the software. Okay, or I cannot register the software. Okay, let me quickly show in a folder. Okay, let me open run it. Okay, update Microsoft update. I put it off as of now. Okay, fine. Let me start it. So now Azure Site Recovery Provider is getting installed on my machine. So we need to give some time to this. So you can see right now, right? The agent is installed right now on my machine, okay? And that site recovery provider is also completed. So let me click on register. Okay, now I need to pass that key, which is I downloaded from here. Okay, let me show you from here. Okay, I downloaded the key. Now I need to pass this key. So let me go back to this site. Okay, let me go to download and give the key. Yes. Okay. Now let me click on next. Yeah, with a proxy server. I don't have proxy right now. That's why I will go with the first option where I don't use a proxy. Next. So now registration is getting started and it will configure in some time. Now you can see, right, that this server is registered with Azure Recovery Vault. Now let me click on finish over here. Let me refresh it. Let me take that out one more time. No. Okay, see. Now you can see, right? This VM host machine is now I can see over here and is connected. So let me move to next. Okay, resource manager is quickly create. So subscription, I am using my subscription over here. The post failover deployment model, I'm using the resource manager over here. I'm not changing anything over here as of now. So we'll move to next. Okay, I will create one policy over here. Policy name is Okay. Hello. Copy frequency. I will keep it 30 seconds as of now. Query point is 2, and a persistent snapshot frequency in hours 1. Clear. Okay. And then initial replication start time is immediately set over here. So target is my Hyper-V, and my source is Hyper-V, and target is my Azure. Okay. So click on OK right now. So replication policy will be creating right now. Okay, so it is, the policy is created right now. Okay, now it is getting associated with my raga-dev-hyper-v-v recovery vault. Okay. So now you can see over here, right? The application policy is created, and now this policy is associated with my recovery service vault. So we'll go to next, and we'll click on prepare. Okay, this is my summary of the prepare infrastructure option. Okay, we'll wait for some time. So we have completed the first step, prepare infrastructure. So we'll go to next. Okay. So let me go back to recovery service vault over here. Let me click on this, and then let me go to set recovery. Over here, I have done with this prepare infrastructure step. Now I will go to enable replication. I will click on this. So this is my service recovery vault. Let me click on next. Over here, I will set up my target environment. Okay, where I'm going to do a failover. So resource manager, I will keep as it is. Storage account, I will use my storage account, which I created earlier. Then I will select a DR VNet. Okay, and subnet is already, you can see right now. So let me go to next. Okay, so I will select prod VM, which I can see right now over here. Okay, let me go, let me check. Okay, fine, let me go further. Now I have to select a OS type. Let me put Windows. Okay, the disk is as it is. Okay, fine. So let me click on next. Okay, and you can see right now, like the application policy is this, which I created in first step, prepare infrastructure stage. Then 30 seconds by copy frequency, recovery points retention is 2 hour, app consistent snapshot frequency is 1 hour, so initial replication start time is immediately, encrypt data store on Azure, I set it off right now, VMM setting is not configured. Let me click next. Now I will click on enable replication. Okay, so we'll wait for some time. Once it is complete, I can see the VM under the replicated item section. So we have done with the enable replication as well. Okay, so let me go to PPT. And now I have done with the first step where I implemented the protection of Hyper-V virtual machine. Now the next point is about review the Azure VM replication setting. So let me show you that as well here. So if you go to replicated items, over here you can see the VM, right? And you can see the replication health is healthy. And shard is protected. Okay, if I click on this, right, then I can see your actual status of my VM. Okay, so let me expand it. So now you can see that, right, over here, there is no error in that replicated item. Okay, so recovery service vault name is Raga DR vault, replicated application policy is Raga-DR-policy. Then target storage account, which is my storage account, which I given during the setting up the replication. Then operating system is Windows. Our target network is my raga-dr.vnet. And then this is my source location, like raga-dev-hyper-v. And this is the VM ID. And target size is standard B1 MS. And protected disk is 1, right? Okay. So now I think I'm set, right? So when you actually start replicating, okay, it takes some time. Okay, so we'll see that one by one. Okay, now the next part here is that, let me go back to PPT. Now I will do actual failover. So I will perform the step three. Okay, so before doing the actual plant failover, I will rather go with the test failover. Let me click on this. Page is loading. Test failure and plant failure is almost same. Okay, so I will show you the test failure first. Okay, I will keep it as it is right now. Okay, I have the recovery point over here. I will choose this recovery point as of now as a default. Okay, and then I will select my Saga test unit. Okay. Okay, now my payload is started. So what I will do now, I will wait for some time. So machine is ready, then I will log it into that and I will check the file. So you can see over here, my test payload is initiated. So if I click on this, it has a 4-step, which I can show you right now. So if you see over here, the status, right? So it contains a 4-step, the prerequisite, check for test failure, successful, now starting the test failure. So it is in progress. Once it is done, then the third stage, it will create a virtual machine. And fourth, it will start the virtual machine. So this is the 4-step. It will perform one by one. So you can see right now, the test failure is completed. Let me check what is the VM I can see over there. Let me go to virtual machine. Okay, so now you can see this, right? This is an additional prod VM dash test is getting created over here. Okay, and it's ready now, we can use it, all right? Okay, so we are done with the test failure. So we will do actual failure, right? So let me go back to my test failure option over here. Okay, let me click on this. Okay, let me refresh it first. Refresh. So let me clean off the test failure and then I will start the actual failure. So let me click on this. Okay, let me click on test failure and then we will go with the unplanned failure. So if you see this option, the two options they are given, one is a planned failure, other is a failure. So failure is nothing but unplanned failure. So we will test this right now. Okay, so let me quickly clean up it. So my cleanup test for failure is completed. Okay, I will start with actual failure. Okay, let me click on this. Okay, it will take some time to get a recovery point. And once the recovery point is available, then I can start. Okay. So you can see right now, okay, I have the latest process recovery point. Okay, I will start with that. Okay. Okay. Now I have started with the actual failure. Okay. So it takes some 10 to 15 minutes to complete. Okay. Once it is complete, then I will show you the VM, which is restored, and I can show the content inside that. Okay. So we'll wait for some time more. So now you can see the failure is completed. If I click on this, you can see all the steps over here. So when I click on the failure, the job will start. Okay. So let me show you that. Okay. I think it's completed now. So the job is completed now. You can see failure completed without any issue. So we are in a boost phase now. And I always, so let me show that. Let me go to virtual machine. Can you see over here? The new machine is added over here. Okay, I just added the public IP to this machine to access it. And if I log in inside that, I can see that testdr.txt file. Okay, this is how we conclude our session. Let me know if you have any questions, any feedback.